YouTubers. It's Alfred. Quick video log, Sunday, May 6th, 2007. You know, some people ask me for advice with regard to investments, and they ask me, you know, what do I do personally with my money? Typically, my response is that I keep my money locked up in CDs. You want to see? I'll show you. There's one binder of CDs in a notebook of, you know, 250. And there's another. And there's another. And another. And another. Oh, my God. That's a lot of freaking CDs. I'm finally feeding all these things into my iTunes server, which I'll show you. It's right here. There it is. It's an FF class Mac Mini. Now, what makes it FF class? The fact that it has, like, a redundant RAID array on here, as well as a video input device. And how many songs do we have in this iTunes library? I'll show you. 17,063 songs, 49.2 days of continuous music at 94 gigabytes. If that RAID array fails, you're going to hear me doing for about like 6 minutes. I'll try to record it so you can, like, you know, hear it. Check this out, though. You see, the Mac Mini replaced this FF class JVC, you know, automatic disc changer. How do I open this thing? Yeah, I made those sound effects in my mouth. I gotta feed these into iTunes also. Plus, you know, this growing collection is a lot of CDs. I do personally prefer buying CDs. I like the full album. You know, I like to hear the whole set of music. Nothing wrong with that. I guess I'm maybe a dying breed. I know everyone's just into, like, you know, the one-shot downloads. But I like getting the whole collection of music. Anyway, that's my personal preference. And lots of CDs. I'm still feeding in stuff. The 17,000 is not where it's going to top off. Can you guess? Can you guess how many songs I'm going to have in that thing by the time I'm done? That will be an interesting guess. Come on, just post it. We'll see how close you are. All right? More to come. I'm going to the storage facility because I got to drop that CD changer off because it's too big to keep in the condo. Be back real soon. I'm at the storage facility to drop off some of the electronics, and I'll show you what displaced it when I get back home. But if you notice, you know, from my Tomb and Tomb Raider video, the storage facility was always orange in color. I have to admit, folks, there is a second storage unit, and I'm going to welcome you to storage unit number 619. Here it is, folks. The stuff in this storage unit is going to be giving you entertainment for many years to come. Wait till you see what's inside. Boxes. That's a synthesizer. That's a box for the G5. There's a box for the FF cinema display. Ah, that's a box for the four-core, for my four-core whore. Ah, the old stinky G4 box. Only kidding about the stinky, all right? Come with me for a quick tour of some of the crap that's in storage, that God knows why I'm still saving all this stuff. There is a Mac 512, and from what I remember, it does work, so maybe one of these years I'll boot this thing up. Now a classic collectible. Actually, this one, if anyone remembers, this one was retrofitted with a 5 megabyte or a 10 megabyte hyperdrive, an internal hard drive. Wow, what a hack that thing was. So this was, it was a 20 megabyte, there it is, it was a 20 megabyte hyperdrive. If anyone remembers the hyperdrive, I'll tell you, man, this thing flew for the time when everything else was on floppy. Holy cow. Let's see what else. But we do have, you know, a pair of Powermac 8500 back there, 8500s. There's a full Apple IIe system back there, which you'll see. If any of you are into Xbox gaming, you might be familiar with this. Steel Battalion. Steel Battalion is like a mech warrior game for the Xbox. It's incredible. It was a huge controller with pedals and everything else, and extremely difficult, and I never even opened the damn thing. I got it from eBay like a few years ago because it was very hard to find. Before I know, there's a box of bricks in there. So, yeah, I'll have to open that up on cam and see what's inside, but more to come. Have you ever seen the Apple IIc portable? I'll tell you, this is such a cool machine. You know, it came out a little bit after the Macintosh launch, so it was a little bit confusing back then in the early retail days. I mean, were you selling a Mac that had very little software but a cool interface, or an Apple IIc more compact, more cost-effective, tons of software color, but, you know, not really a major jump in technological advancement, but we sold a lot of them. It was very cool. Here it is. There it is, you know, 1 megahertz, whoa, might be 0 megahertz after I drop it, 1 megahertz portable computing with a handle. Very, very cool. Thank you, Steve Wozniak, for this one. If anyone's into synthesizers, here's a full Alpha Centauri synthesizer. That's right, folks. A full-blown Alpha Centauri. The Alpha Centauri synthesizer, I think it dates back to like 1981 or 82. It connected to an Apple II and a pair of sound cards called the Mountain Hardware Music System. It had a light pen. It was effing incredible. And it does work. I have hooked that thing up several years ago. It does fully work, and you will see a video on that. It's extremely rare. What's very cool about it is back in that era, you know, everyone was dealing with a monophonic synthesizer that can only play like one or two notes. This freaking thing can play 16 notes at a time. Expensive as hell. I'm not even going to tell you how much it was. But, more to come. And there's tons of, archival books and magazines and Apple computer and all the touch of cool stuff in here. So, we'll dig through it. And in there are a bunch of video game systems, including the Atari Jaguar. And if anyone knows that system, they had a game called Alien vs. Predator. Holy cow. The game was so intense. I jumped so high, I broke a chair. I did. It was good. Anyway, you'll be seeing that as well, so stay tuned. Let me just pack up this stuff and get out of here, because it's freaking hot! Look, we're answering the question, do fish sleep? I just came in to feed the fish. Look at the trigger. He's asleep in the rocks. Look, he's starting to wake up now because I just turned on the office light, but look at him, he's sleeping in the rocks. Is that unbelievable? He's sleeping nose down in those rocks. Look at that. Look at that. So yes, they do sleep. Except for this guy, he's nocturnal. It's a little late night fine dining for the boys. Here we go.
Look at that bass, he's a new addition. Look at his mouth stuffed. Look at that trigger taken away from the dogfish, you pig.
I cleared some room for something very special. It's a new piece of Lumonics artwork that was designed for my home. It's done by the same people that brought us this piece called Star Map, which many of you have seen. It's the same people that brought me the Spear of Tanner piece, which is really pretty cool. Really illuminates Pinhead really well. Also the same people that brought the very cool green fountain. Also the same people that brought this piece to my home. Look at this thing. That's very cool when we look at it from down from the top. Look at that, is that incredible? Okay, you ready to see the new piece? I bring to you Stratosphere. There it is. Is that incredible? The piece is called Stratosphere. It's a pretty big fountain. I guess it's FF class compared to the other one I have. And the thing that's really great about this fountain is that it gives off some nice audio that helps diffuse my tinnitus when I'm sleeping. Has two LEDs that are kind of out of sync, and it gives a great lighting effect. So that is Stratosphere and a new addition to my home. I hope you guys will enjoy it. Thanks for watching.